deputy and members of the information and publicity committee, under which this sort of activities fall. Fellow councillors, the acting town clerk, heads, other members of management and staff of council, Zifa CEO Jonathan Mashingaite, the women football executive led by Mama Gambe and Mama Langa, Zifa honorary members, Zifa secretariat, and Zifa assembly members. Obviously, very special, Mr. Barry Dakaha. You took us back quite a few years to see you here. I'm not a politician. I'm a councillor. So my speech is going to be doctored and shortened. Well, let me go back to Mr. Mashingaite. In 1985, yes, I was the team manager of the team that won the high school's soccer tournament cup. And Mr. Mashingaite was one of my best players. He was a defensive linkman, I think. Yes, we had a great team. We played against Highfield and we chaired them big time. So I also have a football CV, if you don't. I also had the joy of trying to get Wimbledon in 1988. I had secured Wimbledon to come and play in Zimbabwe against Highlanders, Dynamos, and Caps. They were going to play in this country 4 days after winning the FA Cup. And I was working as a young, bright young boy. I used to be very sharp then. It was blocked because Zifa bungled, and also because President Banana wanted the state of Tornadoes to be included in the tour. And I was saying Tornadoes has got no supporters. So we disagreed. So those are the two reasons why Wimbledon did not play in this country. To the girls who've made us really proud, mighty warriors, I was listening to your game as we were coming from Morton Jeffrey, and when the final whistle was blown, I posted on my Facebook, Rio 2016, here we come. It was a moment of national pride, national joy. You've really made us proud. That's why we all managed to squeeze out of our busy schedules all to be here to celebrate this event at Town House. Figo, you've spoken well, you've played well, you and your team have taken us to Rio. Those achievements are rare, particularly for our country, for a number of reasons. It's a matter of national pride, national delight that you are headed for Rio. So what the journey you completed in to Faro on Sunday is almost a full journey, although we expect more out of you. I spoke to Christine Hislop, who was one of the 1980 Golden Girls about 2 hours ago, and I phoned her and I said, Christine, this is what's happening in hosting the girls. And says, please, on behalf of the Golden Girls, hockey girls who won the gold medal in Mexico, in Moscow, in 1980, says, please give the girls our heartiest congratulations and our best wishes. And she says, even if you don't win, we don't want to put you under too much pressure. She says, even if you don't win, the exposure, the joy of having made it, you will tell your grandchildren. I started representing this country when I was 22 years old, going overseas. I will tell you that exposure, you will love it. You will come back a different person, apart from the football. Go and do the football, but that whole trip will be a life-changing experience. We, like the rest of government, council is part of government, make no mistake. We take pride in this qualification. We're excited that Zimbabwe has joined Brazil, the hosts, France, Germany, Colombia, and our neighbor South Africa in qualifying for this sporting jamboree from August 5th to the 21st in Brazil. And I'm making proposals to the city fathers that funds permitting, they must allow at least two city mothers to accompany you. I hope the city fathers will find it appropriate to allow city mothers to go and support the Golden Girls. If they don't agree, we just put a petition. I'll give you all 46 councillors to write to each one of them and to see which one says no. The qualifiers are still going on in other regions that include Asia Pacific and Oceania. Some of the qualifiers completed the exercise in March 2016, but you've sealed your invitations already, which shows your class and your quality. Don't worry about not having paid another team. Zimbabwe is a country that lost on technicality. It's our time to win on technicality. You have no apology. Go away and start doing your job. And from the mayor of the city of Harare, our prayers are with you as you go in 2016 to represent our beautiful country in football. Even though you'll be joined by athletes from other disciplines, soccer appeals to more people than all other sports combined. And for that reason, expectations are higher that you do well in Rio. That is my challenge to you. City fathers, I come back to you again. You have heard the lamentations about the struggles that the girls have gone through. You have a duty to be city fathers, white, diverse, circumspect, and embracing. I charge you to go back to your drawing board as councillors to see how wide your small budget can go so that we widen our involvement. We have a duty to the minutiae of this world that they don't walk by bus to go and do boxing. We have to find ways of playing a slightly bigger, wider part. Remember when you set foot in Rio that the stadiums that you are going to be playing have hosted some of the world's greatest footballers, the likes of Ronaldo, Ronaldinho, among others. Just last year, the Men's World Cup finals were staged in Rio with the home of football. So you are going to a truly sentimental place. We'll give you a befitting send-off when the time to go to Rio arrives. We may send a delegation from the city to watch some of your games if they can afford it. Once again, congratulations, Makoroko, Toto, Ampio, the attendant.